Hey everybody, welcome to CRNT Designers. This is Chetan and in this tutorial we are going to create a rope dart. It is a martial art weapon. So now let's get started. To make the model, we need to add a cylinder and we will go with 8 words. After that, go to the orthographic view and then go to the edit mode. Then scale the cylinder along the z-axis. Add a center loop cut like this. Select these bottom words and move them along the z-axis like this. And then you need to scale them along the x and y axis. Then adjust their position. After that, here you need to select the words and then right click connect vertex path. Now just adjust their position along the z axis. Now you need to select these words and you need to scale them. So just select the words and then scale them along the x and y axis. After that, turn on that x-ray mode, select the top words and move them along the z axis. And now you need to add few more loop cuts and you need to create the curve structure. So that's why add a loop cut and then scale it along the x and y axis. Add few more loop cuts and create that curve structure at there. And then select the top face and then delete it. Now you need to add a few loop cuts like this on each plane. So add 3 loop cuts on each plane. And now the next thing, you need to add a cylinder. So shift A, add a cylinder. And we will go with the 32 words this time. Okay, just move it along the z-axis and give the right position to this cylinder. Go to the edit mode and then turn on that snapping option and vertex snap should be on. After that, you need to select the words with the selection tool and move it by pressing G and snap it to the words of the cylinder. Same thing here, select the words, move it and then snap it to the words of the cylinder. And now you can take the symmetry along the x and y axis. So here we have got the circular form at there on the top. Then you can hide that cylinder. Now you need to go to the edit mode, select these words and you need to use the edge slide. So select the words and then press double tap G for the edge slide. And here we want to create the harder edges for that dart, so that's why you need to use the edge slide here. So just use the edge slide and create those harder edges. After that, you can take the symmetry along the x and y axis. Then select these words and use the edge slide at here also. To create the harder edge at the joining part of those two planes and then take the symmetry. And now you can see it's look good. Just select these words and use the edge slide and move it along the z-axis. Here you need to create the curve structure with the help of words. So use the edge slide and create that curve structure at there. And just refine your model by moving the words here and there and giving them right position. It will give you a smooth form on your model. And then take the symmetry along the x and y axis. And now you can add the sub-D modifier. Increase its count up to 2. And then you need to add a loop cut. So add a loop cut like this, add a few more loop cuts like this. And now I will use the knife tool here. So use the knife tool and create a cut like this. Press Z and then select the next point and then press Enter to complete that operation. In this way, you can create a cut with the help of knife tool. Then select these words and use the edge slide at there. Because we want to create those pointed corners, so that's why we need to add few more loops at there to maintain that form. So that's why use the edge slide at there to maintain that form. Then we will get those pointed corners. And now just adjust the position of the words and try to maintain the good edge flow at there by giving the right position to the words. And now you can see it's look pretty well. And that's look good, decent, shade smoothed. So now I will work here. It's look little bit flat. We want to create a dome shape at there. So that's why add loop cuts like this and then select these faces with the shortest path selection. So just select the faces with the shortest path selection and then delete this. Select this edge loop and use the loop tool and then circle option. Then press F to fill the gap. And then extrude it along the Z-axis and then scale it down like this. Give the right position to this and then add a bevel on it. So Ctrl B to add the bevel. And it's look pretty well. And then select this dome shape and then scale it along the X and Y axis and create a decent one. Now you can see it's look pretty well. What can we do with this? So here we can select the face and press I for the insert operation. Then press M and merge at the center and now it's look pretty well. In this way you can create that pointed form. And then add few more loop cuts on the model to get a more decent look. And then I will turn on that cylinder and then here you need to select the top and bottom faces of the cylinder and then delete them. Okay, select both objects now and then join them together. Go to the edit mode, select everything and press M and merge by distance. Double words will get merged. You can see the 32 words have merged there. And now it's look pretty well. Now just we need to create a little bit of work on this. So just select this edge loop and E to extrude it and move it along the Z axis. And then one more time extrude it and move it along the Z axis and then scale it along the X and Y axis. Just select these words and give the right position to them. And just try to create a decent design at there. So just select this edge loop and press F to fill the gap, then use the insert operation. And then use the extrude operation and move it little bit down along the Z axis. After that use the insert operation. And then add a loop cut like this. Then select these face loops and use the insert operation to add more loop cuts at there, which will support the form. Then select these faces, use the insert operation. Select this face loop, use the insert operation. And then here you can add one more loop cut like this. And now you can see it's look good. Then here you can create the chord based topology. So select the words, right click, connect vertex path and create a right topology at there. And then you can add few more loop cuts on the model. And just you need to create a little bit of design at here. Press I for the insert operation and create that ring form at there so it will look pretty well. Then select these face loops and press I for the insert operation. After that just add few more loop cuts on the model to maintain the form and to get the decent results. In this way you can create this kind of dart model. You can see its topology, you can see it from the Matka view and that's look pretty well. So you can see we are able to create a decent edge flow on the model, so that's why we are getting the smooth design at the smooth form at the. I will try to upload its UI unwrapping and texturing part. I have an amazing news for you guys. We have launched the Black Friday sale on our website where you will get 50% off on our latest release Nuts and Bolts Volume 1 Hard Surface Kit Bash. You will get 50 designs of the nuts and bolts in this kit bash. If you are Indian audience then you can pay with the rupees with the UPI cards and other options. If you are non-Indian audience then you can use the PayPal and cards. And you can contact the crntdesigners@gmail.com. So now I am going to show you how you can buy this product. So click on this buy now button and you will redirect to this payment gateway. You can read all the details about the products and terms and conditions. Then you need to fill your details here and then click on this pay option. And you will get these different options for the transaction. Indian customers can pay with the cards, UPI, net banking and other options. And if you are non-Indian customers then you need to press on this wallet option, then there is a PayPal and you can see the change in the currency and then press pay and you will redirect to the PayPal checkout. And here you can fill your details with the PayPal account or you can pay with the cards and debit cards also. Then you need to fill these details and you can proceed to pay. After paying you will redirect to this drive link where you can get the product. Just you need to download the product and then extract that zip file and then just open that folder and click on this Blender file and you will get your products. This amazing deal is for the limited time, so don't miss it. Get this product. After this Black Friday sale, you will get these products in its regular price. So don't miss this amazing deal. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe our YouTube channel. Bye bye. So next video, take care.